Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Jens Bogren. We're at Fascination Street Studios and I'm gonna show you how to get a great sounding bass guitar using our new product BassKnob STD from Bogren Digital. The session I have here is a song by Felipe Andreoli called Driven. We have his really cool, intricate bass playing, and I also took the time to transcribe it into MIDI. We're gonna see how it plays back with Submission Audio, Umansky, and Groove Bass. Let's dive into my session. All right, so we are inside Pro Tools. We have a bass track up here, a DI. We have the transcribed MIDI bass. And we have stems of the instrument groups, like drums, rhythm guitars, clean guitars, and some keyboards. And down here is my original mix. We're gonna focus on the bass. On here is BassKnob STD. If you're watching this video, maybe you already checked it out. Otherwise, I call on you to download the trial and check it out. It's a super, super simple plugin. You open it up, looks like this. And you basically have two channels, clean and dirt, and then one knob. And many other bass plugins, once you turn the gain dial, you basically get, you know, really low volume or really high volume, and it doesn't really break up. But this one, both in clean and dirt, you really get that preamp and power amp tube distortion thing going. In the dirt channels, there is also a very popular bass distortion in front of the amp. So this works really cool. I can just also quickly show you that there's an input and output thing here. That way you can calibrate and make sure that the STD is fed by a decent amount of gain. You can actually get pretty different tones whether you have a low input and a lot of gain, or less gain and a high input. That's something to experiment with a little bit. There's a tuner. There is a cab off feature in case you're using a third party or external IR loader and your own base IRs. Basically just turns off the cab inside the plugin, but leave the amp going. All in all, one knob, clean and dirt channels. That's it, folks. So let's have a listen. Let's just bring this one up to its factory default and see how it sounds. I have an EQ there. Let's just bypass that one as well. So we're playing my stems from this session along with the bass. Bass STD. As you can hear, it's almost impossible to make this thing sound bad. You have all these different timbres and different sounds inside just the one knob and maybe the input gain and the two channels. This whole plugin is actually based on my favorite chain with a really popular American amp and a 8x10 inch speaker cabinet that I use, and I've had this rig used on so many productions, really. And I've sort of perfected the chain, and one day I decided to model the whole thing and get it into a plugin, which is the STD. So unlike many other amp sims on the market, it's also just, you know, sits really, really well in the mix because there's more to it than just the amp. It is my whole chain that is modeled here. And it works really, really nice. For this particular mix and song, you know, it's basically like a solo bass album he has here, and obviously the bass should be maybe louder than a normal mix or a normal song. So for this one I would probably maybe use some pre-EQ on the DI before the STD, and or some post-EQ to make the bass come through a little bit more maybe. So let's see what we can do. So an EQ that just highlights more of the high mids and the mids, maybe take off a little bit of the low mids, will make this bass come through as a solo bass instead of a more of a backseat bass. But there is no right and wrong here, really. And it's also impossible to have a sound that works for everything. You always need to modify the sound a little bit depending on the elements of your mix, obviously. But as you can see here, I personally feel that I don't need a compressor. I don't need some sort of a multiband thing that I see a lot of people use. If the source is good enough, that should not most of the time be needed. There are things that could be done here. If I had the full mix, I could use like a gate that ducks for every kick hit, so leave a little bit more space for the bass and kick drum together. But it's, you know, some icing on the cake maybe, but not really necessary. I am, however, going to show you one trick that I usually do. I'm going to just create a little master fader here inside Pro Tools. Go out to the out 3-4, which is to my summing mixer here. I should also say that these instrument groups that I have in my session, they go out to my summing mixer, they're coming back clean into my session again here, where I can do some like overall automation. This is just how my mix setup is looking. I could just mix this completely inside the box as well. And then I do have a little bit of like mix EQ on the whole thing, which is something I can show you how it sounds without. Just gives that little bit overall mix thing. I've seen some people being very worried if I don't show absolutely everything that's happening inside the mix, so I figured that could be good. And after that, I also have a limiter. It's just a safety limiter for the whole thing. And let's see, okay, so I promised to show you a trick. Let's see what we got. There is a plugin that I tend to use quite often. That is called the CLA Bass. And that one has some magic for bass that usually goes completely overboard, to be honest. But what I usually use is that I use it in parallel. I can use something like Patchwork that could load up plugins. And then I load up the CLA like this. Some parallel compressor, maybe some extra distortion, some like chorus widening thing. And then I do that just very little. So I have a mix thing here inside Patchwork where I could start at zero. So what that does is that I can mix in, it stays very, very nice and phase coherent. And then I can mix in some parallel compression, distortion, and pitch widening at the same time. It's pretty subtle. If I do this a little bit more extreme, something like a lot of widening, a lot of compression, a lot of distortion, you can hear what it does. And then I roll it back, so just like 20, maybe 30%, and maybe a little less extreme settings. And that does make the bass go just sink in a little bit more, make it a little bit wider, a little biter. So this is a trick that I'm using quite often on my own mixes. All right, so this is the real bass. I've been showing how well it works with the STD. I'm gonna remove this extra gimmick I did. I know a lot of you guys maybe don't have a bass, or you know, just program the bass instead. There are some really good tools for that out there. This is not the perfect song to to program because it's so so much stuff going on. But I took the time. And I have a MIDI track of Philippa's bass. For that, we're gonna use the Submission Audio really, really cool basses. We have the Groove Bass right now. I also loaded up the Umansky Bass, which is a little bit more like piano, whilst the Groove Bass is a little bit more low-end focused. We can listen to that, just the with the DI coming out of it. That's the Groove Bass, and the Umansky one sounds like this. Funky. So let's see how this works. Let's just put the bass knob on here. We can start by with the Umansky bass. It's a bit more piano. So first, with out again. Pretty good for only DI, to be honest. Let's try with the STD amp, just at default settings. Well, if that is not a perfect rock tone, I don't know what is. Let's try with the Groove Bass instead. First without the STD again. Cool. Sounds pretty good already, just with the DI there. Let's see how it sounds with the bass knob STD at default settings. I think the Groove Bass here for this track probably needs a little bit of the same treatment as we did with the Philippa's bass. Just a little bit more high mids to get it through. But it sounds really, really cool, like the rock sound that this character brings. To be honest, you don't have any of the out-of-tune issues that you might have with a real bass player. And it's pretty cool. Let's see, I put a temporary EQ on here. Yeah, basically just taking out a little bit of that like high bass, low mids, pushing a little bit more the mids and the high mids, and the bass comes through a little bit more like Filippo would have wanted in his mix. Try the submission audio stuff out. I'm impressed. I do tend to get quite a lot of sessions these days in for mixing that actually is using this these things. But both the groove bass and the Omansky bass are proving themselves really good in here. Put some BassKnob STD on and, you know, magic is happening. So, that's it for the walkthrough of Filippo Andreoli's Driven and the BassKnob STD, the submission audio bass plugins. And I hope to see you again in the next video.